very important aspect. I must say that, see, on this aspect, we are working hard, and it's a good initiative by the Department of Public Health Dentistry that they have organized this program. So we are very much supported by our president, sir, as well as our associate dean of Nasir Patel Dental College, Dr. Vilas Patel, is also actively involved all kind of activity of the our institute. And really, it's a good, I hope all participants will enjoy learning about discovering literature beyond searching. But it is very important to start with any research activity. And our speaker of today's program, Dr. Puneet Gupta, actually, he conducted one workshop also in our institute that was as a part of PG convention of Indian Prosthetic Society, which was hosted by our institute. So once again, thank you, Dr. Puneet, for accepting our invitation, and in spite of your busy schedule, even today you are expecting DCI inspection, then also you have joined with us. I hope we will not disturb you much, and let us have a benefit, or rather let us go ahead with the program. So thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir, for organizing this event and inviting me. And as previously always, you ask me for a new topic. So this time I thought again, I'll come up with some new concept and present to you. So actually what happens is, in that way, it's opportunity for me also to learn new things because you generally don't go for a conventional workshop anytime. You always want something innovative. So it was an opportunity for me to learn something new. And yes, we are amidst a lot of things in the administratively in the department, but we'll try to complete this workshop in a decent way so that the delegates benefit to the maximum.
Yes, good. Thank you.
I now request our head of department, Dr. Ipsita Menon, ma'am, to welcome all the esteemed guests and introduce the guest speaker for today, Dr. Puneet Gupta, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Katie. Good morning to one and all. And firstly, I would like to welcome our Honorable President, sir, Shri Prakash Bhai Patel, sir, our respected Provost and Dean, sir, Dr. J.R. Patel, sir, our Associate Dean, Dr. Vilas, ma'am, all the HODs of our dental department, faculty, postgraduate students, PhD scholars, and my dear students. A hearty welcome to this event and webinar, which is being conducted by the Department of Public Health Dentistry, NPDSH. And I would like to introduce all my delegates to our wonderful webinar speaker, Dr. Puneet Gupta. He has completed his BDS from Manipal Academy of Higher Education, MGS Public Health Dentistry from RGHS Bangalore 2008. Presently, he is working as a reader in Government GDC Indore. He is executive committee member of Oral Health Working Group of World Federation of Public Health Associations, EC member of IAPSG, advisor to Medical Students Association of India. He has published systematic review for Oral Health Group of Cochrane Collaboration, also a member of Cochrane Knowledge Translation Working Group. He has dozens of publications listed in PubMed, and his passion to teach has driven him to conduct courses in India and abroad. His areas of focus are research, tobacco control, to name a few. Thank you, Dr. Puneet, so much for accepting our invitation. And so now the platform is absolutely yours. No more taking more time from you. Over to you, Puneet.
Thank you, Dr. Ipsita. And as discussed, the initial things take around 15 to 20 minutes. So we are not running short of time. So it's around 10:20, and that's the time when I'll start speaking. So welcome to this webinar on topic discovering literature beyond searching. But, okay, Before I start, there's a small disclaimer that I'm not affiliated with any product or any website, and the tools which are mentioned or demonstrated during this presentation are purely for academic purpose, and it's more because I feel that these tools are important, and that's why I want to share it with you. And it's not like I am associated with the company in any form, and I'm this is not sponsored by the company or anything of that sort. The other thing is that this webinar is being recorded for the information of all the participants. And then webinars are actually difficult. So because I'll be speaking and I don't know how the response is. So I'll request the host if they can open the chat to all. And I request the participants if they can quickly type quick feedbacks in the chat, because I have the chat window open. And I'll keep an eye on that. If there are any questions, you can put it in the chat box. So can any of the delegate type something in the chat box just to ensure that it's working? And if there is chance delegate wants to speak, I think they we can let them unmute and ask questions as well. Can we have some chat from the delegates? Can it be enabled? Because that will make the interactive webinar interactive. I'll just wait for a minute if we can get some chat response in the chat window. Can any delegate interact with me through the mic or through the chat? If it is not, then I'll proceed as a one-way communication mostly. Okay. Dr. Kethi says yes. You are a delegate or you are a co-host? Dr. Kethi, you are a delegate or a co-host?
I am a co-host.
I'm not a co-host, and I have messaged you. Hi, did you get my message?
Who is that?
Me, Dr. Ipsita.
No, I have not got that. I think only co-hosts can type. But anyway, let the co-hosts be active and interact with me in the chat.
Yeah, so she will be dealing with the questions later on. So I think we can start with the webinar.
Okay, fine. If it is possible, if you can open it for all, it will be fine. So sure, my first question is, from any of the delegates or co-hosts, can anybody tell who is this person? Can anybody identify who this person is? If you cannot identify, I'll tell you how to identify it as well. You can take out your mobile phones and open an app which is known as Google Lens, and just click a picture of this, and you will come to know who this person is. That is a bit about discovering things. So one of the things is how to discover new things. So you have an app on your phone. It's called Google Lens. Use it and try to discover who is it. And if you can type it in the chat window, I'll proceed to the next slide, and let us see how good you all are at discovering this thing, discovering something new. Could anybody do that? Any of the delegates could do that? Okay, let us not waste a lot of time. This female is Abhi Shampa. Abhi Shampa, she is a London-based dentist. But I don't know her as a dentist. She was born in Sri Lanka. And she is trained very well in Indian classical music, including Sufi music. And I have heard her songs 100 times. A few of them are on YouTube and I have heard them many times, and she's an excellent singer. But I did not know about her. And I came across her only through discovery or through artificial intelligence, right? So you are on YouTube. So you search for certain things. I search for a certain genre of music, right? So YouTube has an algorithm, and then they would suggest me other videos or songs which are similar to what I listen, right? So what is that? That is an artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence is the background behind discovering something new. So I would have never come across this female because I never knew her name and I never knew she existed. But it was because of the YouTube algorithm and the artificial intelligence that one of her songs prompted up on my YouTube search list, suggested list, and I clicked on it. And then at the very first song, I actually fell in love with the ultimate voice she has, and the team, the entire team which she works, they create lovely music if you are into Sufi and Indian classical music, right? So I'll suggest you all to go check her out on YouTube. If somebody is interested to discuss music with me, we can do that. But that would be over a dinner at one of the conferences. And I hope we'll soon have offline conferences where we can discuss other things over dinner and lunches, right? So this thing of discovery or this thing of recommendation is present everywhere, right? You would be very happy if one day you will find one of your class 4 friends on your suggested friend list on Facebook, right? Because you keep adding your friends on your Facebook, and then there's somebody new who was your class 4th classmate, and then he shifted to someplace else, and it was recommended to you that he's your friend, right? So I hope all of you have had that very good moment, right? Very happy with that. So similarly, we were searching for a lot of things during the COVID, and even based on that, Amazon gives us recommendations on new products, right? So there may be some brand which you don't know. If you don't know the brand, you will not be able to search for it, right? You will not be able to search for it. But yes, you can discover it from the recommendation list. You will come to know about new products. You will come to know about new brands, right? So that's how artificial intelligence works, and that's how you develop, how you discover new things. Now, one of the pioneers in this is Spotify. And there was a paper on how Spotify recommends playlists to you, and they have a very complex algorithm. It's depicted in this graph. They use a lot of data on what you are searching, what is the music, what is the voice, and then they'll start recommending you music according to that. So you can just imagine how much of programming and other things have gone into this thing, recommending music to you, right? So they are one of the pioneers, and I don't know, they may have some patents and all that, right? But even Amazon has their own technology wherein they'll recommend you things. And that's the game changer many a times. So do you think we can have a Spotify for articles, scientific papers? Yes, we have a Spotify for scientific papers as well. But before we see that, there's something else. It's also important. When we were in class 10th, we were told that computer is a completely obedient machine provided user types everything right. So it's garbage in, garbage output. So what you are searching for will decide what you will get, what recommendations you will get. So this is a classical case wherein somebody objected to the ads which were coming on the IRCTC website, and the IRCTC replies that this is mainly based on your browsing history, right? So if you log into YouTube and if you are searching for cat, they'll always recommend you cat videos and videos which will catch your attention, right? The JCB and people falling off and all. So if you click more and more on that, then the recommendations will move in that direction. But if you go for things which are relative to research or productivity or your music type, then the recommendations which YouTube gives will be more towards that side, right? But even today, I don't think I ever clicked on a cat video, but still at times YouTube sends me some of these links because I know they are strong magnets which attract you, and once you get into that, you'll keep watching those videos, right? So it increases their app time and all. So anyway, but you have to be very precautious on what you are searching. So the organizers, can you still work on opening the chat window for everybody? If it is possible, right?
Sir, it is open now.
Okay. So if delegates can type in something, it will be really great. It will give me a good response. Okay, so now we all know about PubMed. So what we see is in the PubMed, we see the article, the authors, right, the DOI and the abstract. But what is recently it's come up is like these two new things have come up. One is similar articles and the other is cited by, right? So if you are presenting a journal club, yes, definitely you have an article and you have the references. Okay, you have the references. So you have to go to the references, get them, and then prepare your journal club, even for any other research as well. So you go into that and find the references. But what happens is, if it's a recent article, it's good. We generally do journal clubs on very recent articles. But if it is an old article, say even 2015, there would have been articles which would have cited that article. So those articles are also similar, but they have cited this article. So those articles you will not find in the reference list. Those articles you will find it cited by. So if there's an article of 2018 which has cited this 2015 article, so you many a times you'll find these articles in cited by. Okay, so that is what is meant by cited by. So references and citations are different. Okay, and then we have these similar articles. Okay, then we have these similar articles, right? So we had this review on Pitten-Fisher and fluoride varnish. So it shows me articles, and then there's a place where we say see all similar articles, right? See all similar articles. So this is how you are going to discover new literature, right? So I am still not sure if some delegate can type in and give me a response as to have you ever done this discovering literature using similar articles? Can we have some response from the delegates? I am still not sure if delegates are able to respond. Okay. Now I think yes. I think now everybody can, yes. Okay. So you all know that this thing, discovering literature is important, right? Discovering literature is a new concept. Okay. So, okay. So are you all happy with the way we should discover new literature? What do you feel about, before I start to demonstrate certain things, what do you feel about this discovering literature? On a scale of 5, how many points would you give it? Can you quickly type? This new way of discovering literature, from 1 is I don't like it to 5 is like I like it a lot. This way of discovering new literature using PubMed. So can 5, okay. Anybody else can give 4? Any other responses? Tedious and time consuming, but 4, Ritu, 4. Okay. Anybody else? 4. 4, 3, okay. Now we are going on lower scores. I'll wait till somebody puts a 1. I'll wait till somebody puts a 1 up there. So nobody is putting a 1 and everybody is happy with the webinar wherein we'll demonstrate how to discover literature, and they feel it's moderately okay, if not very good, right? So, but the thing is, I am highly inspired by movies, and the last movie I saw was Bell Bottom. And the one dialogue which I liked was, it's not over till it's finally over. Right. So, and that I wanted to incorporate that in the presentation. So what we are doing is, now let me start with the area of interest. And that is, this webinar is not about PubMed and looking for similar articles on PubMed or on Google Scholar. Right. I am taking it to the next level, and I'm introducing a software which is known as ResearchRabbit. I think you can see my Gmail screen, right?
Yes, sir.
So let the actual game begin now. Let us talk, come to the point, and let us let me introduce you to this new app, which is known as ResearchRabbit. Now, I am sending you this mail as well as I put it in the chat. Okay. And all of you will receive this mail. If you don't find it in your inbox, just check it in the spam, because I'll tell you the reason. Because there are a few links in the mail. So sometimes it throws the mail in the spam if you send certain links or email IDs, right? So just check it. If you don't, if you have not received the mail within a minute, just check it in your spam, and also it's there in the chat window. Okay. So now let us see what ResearchRabbit is. It says, reimagine research. We are rethinking everything, literature search, alerts, and more. Alerts also will come to know. Never miss a thing. Visualize your papers, discover author networks, and share your collections, right? Recharge your, ready to supercharge your flows. It's the Spotify for papers. It's a little expensive in the sense it will take your time, but not your money, right? So you'll get personalized digests of recommended this thing. You'll have interactive visualizations. You can share it. And I said it's expensive in the way that you'll have to give your time to it. But they are committed to offering this service free for researchers every time. That's their commitment. And we are still not very sure what their business plan is. They work on citations, but they also have some secret recipes, some algorithms which they cannot share with us. But let us see how well it can work for us, right? So the website for this is researchrabbit.ai. So once you click on that, what you have to do is you have to go to sign up. And if you can see the chat window, I have given you all the instructions on how to do that. So one of the things is you need an institutional email ID. Right, you need an institutional email ID. So I am using the departmental ID of the college. So in case they have anything, we'll just give a password which you can change later on. So let us see if they open this. Okay, so department. Yours is NP Dental College and Hospital.
Yes.
Okay, now the thing is they have a wait list. Okay, they have a wait list, but if you want to skip the wait list, you can use this referral code. So I hope we will get instant access to this thing. I'll have to type that 5QRXMZQ and because I have a lot of windows open on my screen, so I couldn't find the submit button, right? Now, also the thing is, now we are in the Research Rabbit app. So there are two different apps. One is called the researchrabbit.ai. The other is known as researchrabbitapp.com. And we are in here, and now we will start exploring this. We'll start exploring this app. Now, for those who have a Gmail ID or a Hotmail ID, they may feel that they may not be able to access this app. Again, you just have to mail Team Rabbit. I have sent that email ID. You have to just mail them that this is my email ID. I had attended a webinar. This is the referral code. So kindly give me access to Research Rabbit. And I have also sent them the list. So within a couple, for me, it took 2 to 3 days. They activated my account. That was less than a month ago. So you can also do the same, and you can get started with Research Rabbit as early as possible, because if you give it time and if you don't start using it, then again, it may not be of a lot of use to you. Right. So now, are we ready to move and see how it can be helpful for us? So again, now as we started, so Research Rabbit initially does not know anything about us. So we'll have to give it some input information. So the first thing is you can go through the tutorials, but what you can also do is you can add a collection. I close the chat. So this is a untitled collection. Now you can I'll just put it as test collection. Anybody has any topic in the mind? Anybody has any topics in mind? Okay, let's keep so untitled. So now let's just keep it a test collection. You can give it names like library dissertation or a specific areas of focus. So what you are going to do is you have created one collection. You can also create new collections. I think we've just started, but as you use, you will get a button of creating new collections. So once you create a collection, you have to add papers there. Okay, add paper. So what I can do is I can add paper either by title. Title may, if I know the FPKC of chlorhexidine, I can give the title and then just search for that paper. Okay, so it gives me certain recommendations, right? Some articles, and it was a very generic thing. So if you can see, they all have this in the title. Also, if you can use the PMID or the DOI and add that paper, or if you are using a citation manager like Mendeley or Zotero, so you can export a list of citations from these in BibTeX or RIS format, and you can import it in your citation. So these three are the ways to add particular papers to this particular collection, right? So the other way is to add by search. Now search again, we'll just write FP. I have still not added any क्या कहते हैं पेपर वी जस्ट सॉ वी जस्ट इट जस्ट रिकमेंडेड वी हैव स्टिल नॉट एडेड एनी दिस थिंग राइट सो इफ वी सर्च नाउ अगेन वी विल जस्ट सी okay so again we get this if the spelling is right it will give us certain recommendations now the best part is I have closed the chat let me just check one second I just opening the chat if there's something anybody has in particular which we can explore here Kritika yes you can log in individually as also I just used this email id because it had an edu.in ending right so you can always get access through your gmail id and can we access old articles till 1950s so the answer is I am not very sure but what happens is the research rabbit says that the search comes from certain databases so their database where they search is second only to Google Scholar but the problem with Google Scholar is that they also show a lot of predatory journals right so at least they search all the academic databases and push you articles and I'm sure they would even search for the old articles if it is digitally available in one of these databases, right? So that's there. Or the other greatest thing is there's no recommendation, but let us see. We can also search on PubMed. And when we search on PubMed, we can use the PubMed search terms, right? I'm not sure if you all are trained in searching PubMed effectively, but if I say Puneet Gupta AU, it will search for all papers which has Puneet Gupta as the author. So let us see if it searches. So you can give and not, so your entire PubMed search strategy can be put here. And that's, now this is not a recommendation. This is the PubMed search result because we are doing a search or based on PubMed. It takes some amount of time, probably because the servers are working at back end and they will give us the results. They will show us the results. Taking okay let us search this because this we already had okay so depends whatever you search so let us look at this article Let us take an article from the 16. Okay, so let me add this article to the collection. Okay, and then let us close. And now I have a collection which is known as test, and I have one article in this. Okay, one article in this. So what I can do is I can add a note here, and I say this is the master article. Okay, so I can, today I read this article. So it's a community-based randomized control trial. It's a Lancet article. So I want to repeat that. So it shows that I have made a small note. It's always advisable to make a note and probably delete. Or you can say that this article was referred by this person or that person, right? So now what all can you do if you select this? It shows that this has 23 citations and 22 references. If you click here, it shows all the authors who are there. If you click here, it gives you the abstract, which you can read here as well.
you can expand it and read the abstract. Okay, like this. Okay, then you can add more papers to this collection using the add papers, or you can add more papers using the search. This I have already demonstrated, right? Now let us go to the magical part. Now let me get to similar works. So I have started this trying to discover new articles. Okay. So now the best part is when you click on similar work, it shows you 300 papers. So I'm sure there may be thousands of papers related to this particular paper, but it would, based on the relevance, it has shown you 300 papers, and beautifully it has shown it to you in the form of a graph. Okay, it has shown you in the form of a graph. Now the thing is, we can zoom it a bit. Okay, right. So now the thing is, this graph, each dot represents a paper. Each dot represents a paper. If I click on this dot, it is by Oro Beton in 2015. This is the paper, and it opened the paper here. Now another wonderful thing, PDF. The PDF of this paper is open access, like it's not behind a paywall. Just click here and you will download that paper. I think with the screen and everything going, it's a bit it's gone a bit slow. Okay, so this paper is available to us at click, only for those papers which are not behind a paywall, right? So once I click on that, now the thing is, I can see the title, the abstract. Then do you want me to add this to this collection, or do you want me to add this to another collection? Or no, I feel no, this is my master article now. So I'll go into similar work and then create a new network graph for this article, right? Or who are the authors or suggested authors, and what are all citations and references? But let us come back. So you know, you can progressively proceed from one article to the other till you find and start discovering new articles. Okay, so that is it. But let me explain this graph. There are a few more things in this graph. So what I see is, now if you see the size of the dot is based on the similarity. The size is based on how similar they are. The color of the graph is, the more recent articles will be darker in color and the older articles will be lighter in color. Okay, the green dots are the ones which are in the collection, and the blue dots are the ones which are suggested. Okay, so now let us see, if I select this Bhutta. Okay, so now it opens here. Where is it? I think it should open. If I click on this, I think it's the this thing. It's the speed of the internet. Huh. Now this article is opened here. No, so I'll add this to this collection. Okay, so every time I keep adding articles, okay, my suggestion will improve. Let me add a few more. If you ask me personally, I'll suggest you to add at least 5 articles before proceeding. Okay, recommendation is updated. Now let us see if I can add this. Add to this collection. Obviously, I'm just doing it randomly, but if you do this after reading the articles, your recommendations would all come very helpful. Right now it's just random, so I'm not sure how well it will come. Okay, so okay, so now when I am in this test, I remove abstract and then I see that I have four articles added to this. Now when I click on similar work, now you will get a different graph. It will not be the same graph. Now you will get different graph, and what you see is okay, it's arranging them, and even if you want, you can move the articles differently, right? So what you can see is these articles, no, they are apart. So basically they are talking about different concepts of chlorhexidine, that's why they are apart. Now the other thing is, just let me finish and then I'll allow question. Now what the arrows, these are lines and they are arrows. So what it shows that this particular article has cited this article. So this article of 2013 has cited this article of 2011. So, but yes, definitely it is based on citation, right? It is based on citation. So Google Scholar and PubMed will give you citations. But if you see one article here, it is not cited by anybody, right? It is not cited by any of these articles, but still this article is here. Right, so that means they go beyond the referencing and citation, and they use some artificial intelligence to suggest you articles. Okay, so that is one thing. Okay, we'll go back to. Okay, now based on these four articles, you have a recommendation. This thing. You can also see this as a timeline. The graph is present in two forms, also as a timeline. Okay, so in timeline, what you will appreciate is the articles which are later than 2008 have cited this. So the arrow is towards this article. And this article has cited old articles, which are 2006 and 2005. And this, see, we have one article from 1990, which was cited by these two articles, okay, which were cited by so many articles. So you get some of these things here. So that is about the connection arrows, darker colors. Right now, if you see, you have four green because four papers are in my collection. Okay, if you want earlier work, then it will show you only the work which is earlier than this, and they are citing this. If you want to see later work, now this will be more of the citations, the newer articles which have cited one of these articles, right? So once you do it in a proper way after reading the abstracts, you'll actually understand the things. Like there are certain articles which are talking about chlorhexidine gel, they will be clubbed together. There are certain articles, if they are talking about chlorhexidine mouthwash or chlorhexidine as a disinfectant, so they will be gelled together. They will have more citations, they'll form clusters. So basically, if you're talking about two aspects in this thing, two aspects in a particular paper, so you can easily find out, okay, like these papers were talking about Pitten Fischer sealants, these were talking about fluoride varnish, and these papers were talking about both of them. So if you start understanding and appreciating the graph, it may be of a more help to you. Now, the other thing is, other than the paper graph, okay, the graph is in two forms, the graph and the timeline. You also get this graph of authors, right? So I was keen to know who is this Dhingra. So once I click here, so it gives me a graph of Usha Dhingra, and she's in John Hopkins. I don't know about her work. So what I can do is I can click on who all she has worked with. So again, I'll get a graph of people whom she has worked with, and she has worked with a few people who are from the John Hopkins and somebody even from Annamalai University, CDC, right? So if you click here, then you'll see that in some of the papers, they were co-authors. Or if you don't want to see who a particular person is working with, just click on published work. Okay, so now again we'll get a graph, and okay, so now where is the graph? Okay, so how she has cited other papers of the collection, right? And how she has cited other articles. So you'll find that tree. Okay, you'll find a tree that now this has reached up to zinc supplements, right? So, but somewhere this, even this zinc supplements is connected with this. So I don't know if it is self-citation or what it is, but you see a link here, right? So this paper is talks about newborns. This paper talks about some other thing. We are more into, I think I have added a wrong paper here. So probably if I want, I can remove this paper from the collection, and then again, it would give me a different recommendation. But anyway, you get a brief idea as to how this thing will work. Now, the thing is, there are few other things in that, in this app. One is that based on your collection, every Sunday, they'll send you some alerts only and only if they find some articles, recommendations, which suits one of your collections, and they'll categorize into the different collections you have. And accordingly, they'll send you the recommendation. I just need to move. I need to move. There are a lot of panels on my screen. So that's about the alert. Then what you can do is you can create a new collection. See, I told you new collection has come through. New collection is like you can create a new collection, and then probably you can share it with people. Okay. Description. Okay. So you can share it. Can I have one of your email IDs? Can somebody type their email? Kathy, can you type your email ID in the chat? Okay, so she can add papers to this. Okay, so again, so now she has received an invite. She will receive an invite, and she can access this collection, but for 15 days. And if she continues to, if she joins Research Rabbit, logs in, then that collection will be with her forever, right? So that's how you can share. I already told you how you can take notes for a particular article, and then you can also delete that note if you want. Okay, the note is gone. You can add notes. Okay, and PDF, yes, if the PDF is available, it will be shown to you somewhere here, and you can directly download that PDF and work upon it, right? So with that, I think it's around 45 minutes of demonstration, and I don't think I have tried to cover everything which I had taken a note of, but now I am open to questions or any specific demonstrations. And now, can you give a rating on a scale of 5 as to how useful you felt this new thing will be? Thank you, Amit. Amit is right now is logging in from Saudi. All these 5 ratings are known, and I know a lot of people whom I know have also come for this workshop. So all these are familiar names. I'm not sure. Still, 49 participants are there, but. I'm not sure how the response is. Any questions we can take as we move?
any participant has any question, please do type it in the chat box.
Okay. The more we play with this new tool, we'll learn. Okay. It's not searching, it's actually discovering literature. Searching is a totally different topic and there is a very scientific way on how you should search. Can we access unpublished articles through it? Can we see the articles which are shown come from some databases. So if the unpublished article is available in a database, probably it will show. But I am not very sure if unpublished articles, many times early access is there. So if the early access is available through one of the academic databases, it may be shown. Discovering literature. Sir, some articles are published in native languages. How do we get to those articles? Native language, I am still not sure if they, because again, their search is based on databases. So if the databases, see, if PubMed is there, PubMed has non-English languages which are shown to you when you search for them based on the mesh terms and all. But so I think that those should show here as well. And to read those, you need translators, or the abstract is always available in English. And sometimes you can use Google Translate, or if you have some friends, they can help you translate those articles. We do that, especially in our Cochrane reviews. We have to translate articles in other languages and include them in the reviews. So that's the two strategies we follow. We ask somebody to translate it for us, or we use the Google Translate to get information out of that paper. But I think, yes, because PubMed has non-English languages, so, and this uses PubMed also for searching articles, so I think those articles should show up here. And yes, even the PubMed, if the PubMed has some article dating back to 1950s and you are searching the same concept, I think that article will show up in Research Rabbit as well. And you can just check on that. According to you, which is the best platform to search articles? See, searching is now, there are two concepts in searching. One is sensitive search, the other is specific search. Now, if you are doing a research on, say, chlorhexidine mouthwash, okay, so there are plenty of articles on chlorhexidine mouthwash. And suppose you are comparing it with alum mouthwash or a herbal mouthwash, there are plenty of articles on that. So you don't have time to go through this thing. You don't have time to go through those thousands of articles. So there I will advise you to do a very specific search. Specific search in the sense you have to use all your Boolean operators, your other mesh terms and other strategies which are there for searching literature on PubMed. And if I am not wrong, after the IPS PG convention in Vishnagar, the next IPS PG convention was online. So there, me and my wife, she's a prosthodontist, we presented on PubMed literature searching. And Patel sir, I think he was the president of IPS then, and he gave us the opportunity. So a very specific literature search using PubMed is another, is in itself a half day workshop, how you should use all the Boolean operators and different aspects of the database to search. But once you have narrowed down to very few 10-20 articles, then you, if you want to be sensitive, like there's a new concept and you don't know articles, you don't have articles about that. And the other thing is, like, there are certain things, like one of my PGs, she's doing a study on sense of coherence. So now it's difficult to find articles related to sense of coherence in PubMed, because it's a philosophical concept. We have articles even in education journals or journals of other this thing. Or if you are doing something like analysis of tooth or fluoride analysis in hair, so you will not get everything in PubMed. You may get something in some chemistry journal and all. So in Research Rabbit, it's not restricted to PubMed. You can get something even from environmental studies, or you can get something even from chemistry journals, right? So it actually targets a huge database to come up with the recommendations for your article. So a lot of things like which somebody could have missed at some point of time can be discovered here. So my strategy would be first to do a very specific search, only articles which are very relevant to you. Then you put it in Research Rabbit and then you explore it. It's more about discovering literature, something new which you find somewhere which can be useful to you. So what is the blessed platform to search articles? PubMed, anytime, because they have a team of trained persons who are known as librarians, medical librarians, who are known as indexers, who check through every citation before it is put in there. Will native language articles be available in English? Native language like Spanish, Portuguese, the abstract is generally available in English. The entire article may not be available in English, but you can use Google Translate or other tools to translate those non-English languages to English. We do that and it works, not 100%, but it's quite good. So any other things?
Dr. Puneet, I have a question.
Yes.
Very informative, but I just wanted to know that for the similar authors which you have put in the graph,
okay,
if we want to get the citations, what particular work they have done for any particular geographical location, like for example any cancer prevention work only done in North India, so can we get something like that?
Only in North India. See, actually, here it's not about searching. So what you have to do is you have to find at least 5 articles which talks about prevalence of oral cancer in North India. Add that to your collection, and then the recommendations which will come, they'll show you again, say suppose 300 articles. So what you have to do is, the logic is you read the next article and add only the articles which are related to North India in that collection. So as you add more and more articles to that collection, your recommendations will become more and more specific. The program will know that, okay, you are looking only for this type of articles in North India, cancer prevention in North India, right? So it's same to as what type of music we listen. So if you listen to the same type of music, it's easy for the algorithm to recommend you things which fall in the similar category. So I think that should be the thing. But see, again, if you're talking about oral cancer in North India, it's a very, it has so many articles. So I think it's better to search on PubMed. And in PubMed, yes, you can restrict to geographical locations. There is a mesh term for geographical locations as well. And then if you narrow it down, and then you can put here and try in some other journal. You can always do that after the PubMed search. But mostly for such things, you will get a lot of articles in PubMed only, if you search with all the proper mesh terms and all. And anything else?
I think we'll go ahead. No other questions.
Actually, we are sending a feedback form in the chat box. So everyone, please fill up the feedback forms.
Thank you, sir. It was a very informative session. I now request Dr. Rahul Patel, sir, who is a reader in our department, to give the vote of thanks.
Good morning, everyone. It is my honor and privilege to get an opportunity to express a vote of thanks on today's webinar. Gratitude makes a sense of our past, bring peace today, and creates a vision for tomorrow. On this specific event, on behalf of entire Narsibhai Patel Dental College and Hospital and Sakarchand Patel University, Visnagar family, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to the speakers of today's webinar, Dr. Puneet Gupta sir, for accepting our invitations and enlighten us from your extensive academic experience. We look forward to hosting you again in the near future in offline mode. Thank you, sir. I am heartily thankful to our young and dynamic Honorable President of Sakarchand Patel University and Chairman of Nutan Sarvavidyalaya Keravani Mandal, Sri Prakash Bhai Patel sir, for his constant support and inspirations for upgrading the academic excellence. My sincere thanks to Honorable Provost of Sakarchand Patel University and Dean of Narsibhai Patel Dental College and Hospital, Dr. J.R. Patel sir, for sharing his deep-rooted knowledge and experience in various curricular, co-curricular, and extracurricular activities. It is my pleasure to extend gratitude towards Registrar of Sakarchand Patel University, Dr. P.K. Pandey sir, to be an advisor for us in various academic matters. I would like to extend my sincere thanks to Associate Dean, Narsibhai Patel Dental College and Hospital, Dr. Vilas Patel ma'am, for her constant support and guidance. And a big thank you to our Head of Department, Dr. Ipsita Menon ma'am, for constantly motivating and pushing us on out of our comfort zones in to achieve our best. Many thanks to my fellow colleagues, Dr. Hiran Patel, Dr. Rajesh Patel, and Dr. Dhrusha Nayak, for organizing and coordinating this wonderful event. My sincere thanks to all the Head of Department, faculty member, and PhD scholars of Narsibhai Patel Dental College and Hospital and Sakarchand Patel University for showing great interest in this webinar. This webinar would not have been successful without the hard work of teaching staff, non-teaching staff, and postgraduate students of Department of Public Health Dentistry. Last but not the least, a big thanks to all the participants for taking out their precious time and attending today's webinar. Without you all, this program wouldn't have been successful. Thankfulness is the beginning of the gratitude, and gratitude is the completion of the thankfulness. Yes, once again, I thank each and every one present here. Jai Hind, Jai Jai Garvi Gujarat. Thank you all.
And I thank all the delegates for speaking through the 90 minutes. I think still we have around 50 participants logged in. And you can get back to me through my email if you have any other queries.
Okay, sir.
Thank you so much, Dr. Puneet. I again request all the participants to fill the feedback form, and the e-certificates will be mailed to your registered email ID. And once again, thank you, Dr. Puneet, for accepting our invitation. And it was a brilliant, excellent, and informative session. Thanks a lot.
Yes, thank you all. Thank you, the organizing team. And thank you even for DCI, so that we did not have an inspection today and we could go through with this webinar.
Thank you, sir.
Absolutely. Okay. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. We'll be in touch. वो तो ले लेना है।